In this video, we demonstrate the steps for donning Level C chemical personal protective equipment with a 3M Breathe Easy Papper. Decon operation team members often wear Level C chemical PPE when attending to a patient requiring chemical decontamination. In this video, we will walk through what equipment you will need and demonstrate the steps involved in donning it successfully. You will need the following equipment: a papper and hood, batteries, filters, chem tape or duct tape, an airflow meter, a chemical suit, outer boots, inner boot liners, patient care gloves, and outer gloves. You should also have a chair available that can be used while donning the suit. Start by inspecting all of the equipment that will be needed for the donning process. The seams of the suit should be examined for any tears or broken seals. For this video, we will be using the 3M Breathe Easy Papper. If you are utilizing papers manufactured by ILC Dover, please refer to the Heroes video for ILC Dover papper assembly and testing. While the papper equipment itself may differ slightly, the process for donning the suit and papper will be the same as demonstrated in this video. With this particular papper, there are two types of batteries, yellow and a white. The yellow batteries are rechargeable. The white batteries are not rechargeable. These batteries have boxes on them so you can mark how many hours they have been used. There are three filters required for this papper unit. Each filter is fitted with caps, which will need to be removed prior to attaching the filter to the papper motor. Once the filters are attached, connect the battery and test the papper motor using an airflow meter. Before donning any of the equipment, remove all jewelry and other personal effects. The donning partner should then take and record vital signs of the personnel donning the suit. Remaining hydrated while wearing the suit is very important. It is recommended to drink 1 to 2 glasses of a non-caffeinated beverage prior to donning the suit. To begin the donning process, apply the inner boot liners to both feet. These should be taped at the top to the outer surface of the pants. Be sure to create a tab on the tape's end to aid in the doffing process. Next, step into the suit and pull up to waist level. While sitting on a chair, apply the outer rubber boots over the suit. The rubber grips should be along the bottom to improve traction. Tape should then be applied along the upper rim, sealing them to the suit. Be sure to create a tab on the tape's end to aid in the doffing process. Next, apply the inner gloves. Then stand and put your upper body into the suit. Zip the suit to just above waist level and seal the lower part of the flap using the pre-attached tape. Next, apply the papper motor and belt. Attach the battery to the papper motor, then the battery can be clipped to the belt. The next step is to apply the outer gloves, ensuring the cuff of the suit is on the inside of the gloves. Tape should then be applied along the upper rim, sealing the glove to the suit. Be sure to create a tab to aid in the doffing process. Next, apply patient care gloves over the outer gloves. These will help improve dexterity. Check that the papper tubing is securely attached to the papper unit. Then attach the hood to the tubing. The papper motor should now be started via the switch on the top of the battery. When air is flowing through the hood, it can be put on. The hood consists of two shrouds, an inner and an outer shroud. The inner shroud of the hood should be tucked into the neck of the suit. If the suit has a hood, it should be rolled into the suit. Otherwise, it will obstruct the placement of the inner shroud. Next, the zipper should be closed up to the neck and the flap taped shut. The outer shroud of the hood should then be placed over the shoulders. The support team should be aware of several hand signals that can be used to indicate distress while wearing the suit. Patting the head indicates that the decon team member needs to get out of the suit. Putting hands at the neck signifies the inability to breathe. This concludes the donning process for Level C Chemical Personal Protective Equipment. Be sure to watch the video on doffing Level C 3M Chemical Personal Protective Equipment for the proper doffing procedures.